Friends, welcome to Tech With Us. In this video, we will be trying to understand the differences between general purpose computer and embedded system based on different parameters. So if you have not subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe for more future update. So till now, we have understood an embedded system is a computing system that is designed to serve a dedicated purpose. Mostly, it will be a subsystem to perform a dedicated function within a larger system. Say for example, a GPS navigator or an anti-lock braking system within a vehicle. An embedded system consists of both hardware as well as software. So when chips are built into the system and software is loaded on that for a particular functionality, it becomes an embedded system. So let's try to understand some of the basic differences between general purpose computer and an embedded system. We will be discussing these differences based on four parameters: their purpose, for what they are built for, different constraints, their performances, and the available user interface. General purpose computers are built to be customizable in software, like a desktop PC or a laptop. You can make it to do many things. So while a general purpose computer can be used for multipurpose, an embedded system is only meant for single purpose. Say for example, you cannot take out the hardware of a washing machine and program it to work as a microwave oven. Embedded systems have very tight resource constraints. Resources like power, cost, memory, and even physical size of the system. And also, for an embedded system, in most of the cases, it is required to respond in real time. For example, you don't want your brakes to work after pressing the pedal by a couple of seconds. Unlike embedded system, general purpose computers are richer in resources, and they might face cost and average speed as their constraint. Embedded systems are designed for fixed runtime requirements. These requirements are predefined, and for the system to function normally, it has to fulfill these requirements. In case of general purpose computer, they are much faster and their performance is much better than embedded system. The user interface for an embedded system is not limited to the traditional interfaces like keyboard, mouse, or touch screen, which are mostly available with a general purpose computer. In most of the cases, the user interface for an embedded system is integrated into the real world. They can be as simple as a button or as complex as series of sensors. So that's all I have in this session. In the next session, we will be discussing the microprocessor and microcontroller architectures. And we'll also try to understand how they differ with each other. You can also check out the complete playlist link in the description and comment section of this video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next session.